babies and toddlers really hard to find food that they'll actually eat, but these chicken and corn pot pies, well, they're an absolute treat and they all love them. That includes my baby and my nieces, so I'm going to share the recipe with you. First, you'll need 1.5 litres of liquid. Now, I'm using a homemade stock with no salt in it. That's fantastic for babies, or you could just use water. Because we're adding so much flavour to this, if you're just using water, it works really well too. So we're just going to turn the heat on this, just a medium to high heat, and we're going to add 2 chicken thighs. I like chicken thighs for this because it's quite forgiving when you cook it and it shreds nicely and it's loads of flavour in it. So a good dose of protein for the kiddies. Also, for some extra flavour, a little bit of thyme. So we're adding this to stock or water that is cold. So we're going to bring it up to heat. To this, some root vegetables. We want to get as many vegetables into this as possible. So a carrot. And I'm just going to cut them into little rounds into the pot. And also a potato. So we're going to cut the potato roughly the same size as our carrot so it cooks quite evenly. Now, usually you wouldn't want to add a potato to stock because it's going to make it cloudy, but this is all about saving time and getting dinner on the table quickly for the kids. So we're going to whack that straight in there and it's going to cook all at the same time. So in that goes. We're going to cook this for about 15 minutes after it's come to the boil or until that chicken is cooked and the veggies are tender. Now, while that's cooking, let's get onto the base of the sauce that's going to hold all the chicken and corn together. So 2 leeks, you could use onion instead, but I think that the leeks are milder in flavour. And what I've done is just cut the tops off. I like to keep that for stock, just like a chicken stock, and use the light green part and the white part. And they're really sweet in flavour, and that's why I want to use them for this. They also cook down really fast. All right, this goes into a sauté pan. Just turn that up on a high heat. Some extra virgin olive oil, about a tablespoon, and then in with our leeks. Right, now you don't want this to be too hot because we want to sweat them down so they get really, really soft. So these are going to cook for about 5 to 10 minutes. Just constantly stir them until they're soft. Once that's done, this will almost be ready to go for the next stage. Chicken's cooked and I've taken it out of the chicken stock. I've also got the potatoes and carrot. They're super tender. So we're just going to pop them to one side. I'll mash that in a moment. In the meantime, let's finish off the sauce that's going to put this pie together. These leeks have softened up nicely. So it's time to add a thickening agent, just some flour. In that goes. We want to cook that off. So as if we were making a bechamel for this. And little by little, I'll add this stock so nothing goes to waste. There's about 2 cups of stock here, so small amount in. Give it a stir and you'll see it thicken up straight away because of that flour. I'll add some more. So we're just going to let that bubble away and thicken, and we can add some more vegetables to this. So we've got carrot, potato, leek, and some corn, because I know my baby, he loves corn. My nieces do too. I think it's because it's so sweet. So fresh corn for this, and I'm just cutting all those kernels off the cob. I like to do it this way so it doesn't go everywhere. We used to cut it like this, but it would just go all over the board and on the floor, so it's just easier to do it with a little bit more control. Okay, corn can go straight into the leeks. Fantastic. And stir that through to cook. We really don't need too long to cook the corn. Kind of like it to be slightly crunchy. All right, that's looking very good. Let's add the chicken. So you can shred it or just roughly chop it. It's so tender and soft. Little pieces for little kids. You can see why I use chicken thigh, because it's just so tender and soft. It's not dry at all. And 2 chicken thighs, you can see how much you get there. It's quite a lot. It's going to serve at least 4. Fold that through, and that is good to go. Turn the heat off. Okay, while that cools slightly, let's get onto the mash that's going to cover these pies. So our tender potatoes and carrot, I'll add just a small amount of butter and some milk. And And just with a masher, we'll just mash that. I also like to add a little bit of Parmesan. We don't want to make this super smooth. I want a little texture in this for the topping. All right, mash is done. Let's make two pies. So we'll just top these up with our chicken and corn mixture. By all means, make this ahead of time, freeze it. You can even freeze them in these little pots and then bring them out, defrost them, and then pop them in the oven to heat up for a really quick dinner. So double the portions if you like. Okay, so we want them to be about 3/4 full. Okay. And we'll grab a spoon. We'll top it with our carrot and potato mash just over the top. You can make one large one for the family too if you like. And if you like, just a sprinkle of extra cheese, Parmesan, freshly grated. And that's it. Everything's cooked here. We just want to melt that cheese. So I'm going to pop it under the grill for a moment just to caramelise. How cute are these little pot pies? Chicken, leek, corn, that's really creamy because of all of that sauce, and then lashings of mash on the top with a little bit of cheese. Kids are going to love it, and not just the kids, it's all about feeding the whole family. Everyone's gonna love it, and the best thing about it is you've got your protein there and loads of veggies.